Silence reigns in the maternity ward. Tired women sleep gently, cradling their babies in their arms. A bright shadow appears in the dark corridor. A dark-skinned woman in a medical gown walks through the ward. It looks like a nurse, but if you look closely, you can see that she is highly agitated. The woman enters the room, staring intently into the faces of the sleeping mothers, as if she's looking for someone. Finally, her gaze stops on a young, dark-skinned girl who gave birth to a baby girl 8 hours ago. The woman looks at the baby, and tenderness appears on her face. The nurse approaches the sleeping girl and gently touches her shoulder. The girl blinks several times, comes to her senses, and finally wakes up. At first, she does not understand what her visitor wants from her. The woman explains that she is a medical worker and that the newborn girl has a fever. The girl looks anxiously at the sleeping baby girl. She begins to think that the baby's cheeks are red. Being sick is dangerous for a newborn baby. The girl looks frightened at the nurse. She calms her down and tells her there's nothing to worry about. The woman takes the baby to take her temperature and, if necessary, to give her antipyretic medicine. The young mother nods. She would do anything to help her baby. The woman gently picks up the baby, resting her head on the bend in her elbow, and carries her out of the room. The girl stares after her, eagerly waiting for the girl to be brought back. She doesn't know that the next time she sees her daughter will only be 18 years from now. The little girl has grown up to be a beautiful girl from a well-to-do family. As always, she goes to school in the morning. The girl thinks she is fortunate to have a mother who loves her, and they never quarrel. Crossing the lawn on her way to school, she says hello to the neighbors who smile and wave at her. They are always happy to see this family. The girl is so sweet and polite, and her mother is a wonderful woman. The girl lives in complete confidence that she has a happy life. Her teachers are proud of her at school, and her health is good. She doesn't know that very soon they will turn her life upside down. It all starts with the click of a mouse. Someone sends a sketch of her mother to a Twitter group called Missing Children. After comparing it with the sketch of the woman who stole a baby from the maternity ward 18 years ago, the police conclude it's the same person. One day, on her way home, the girl hears the sounds of sirens and sees police cars pulling up on a small street in front of her house. She is frightened. Has something happened nearby? Maybe there's a criminal loose in the neighborhood, and the police are trying to catch him. The girl is terrified when she sees her mother being led out of the house in handcuffs. The girl rushes to the police and demands an explanation for why her family member is being arrested. The cops push the girl aside and reveal that the woman she lives with had kidnapped her from the maternity ward 18 years ago. The birth mother has been searching for her daughter for 18 years, and now the girl should be happy to be reunited with her family. As she watches the woman who pretended to be her mother for so many years being put in the car, she can't believe what is happening. The girl feels like her world is falling apart. Maybe it's some terrible mistake. Soon it turns out that the police are not mistaken. A genetic test was conducted, which shows that the girl's DNA matches that of the baby who disappeared from the maternity ward 18 years ago. But she is even more shocked and confused when a car stops outside her house, and a dark-skinned woman who looks just like her gets out. The stranger declares that she is her birth mother and wants to hug the girl. A dark-skinned man follows her out of the car and says he is the girl's birth father. No way! The girl retreats frightened. The woman is a stranger. She is the reason her mother is on trial. After a while, the girl is summoned to court to tell the judge and jury about her life. There is nothing unusual in her biography. Like most teenagers, she goes to school, goes out with friends, and prepares for university. She asks for her mother's release, as no charges have yet been brought against her. That's when the girl's birth parents jump up. They scream that the woman who stole their child deserves to spend the rest of her life in prison. The girl claims her birth mother is now on the dock. The birth mother becomes hysterical, and there is a commotion in the hall. The sentence ends for the false nurse, who is sentenced to 18 years. The girl, however, now has the right to choose. She is an adult, so she can decide where she wants to live and with whom she wants to associate. She continues to communicate with the woman who raised her, but at the same time, she wants to try to establish a relationship with her birth parents. Surprised, the girl discovers she has 5 siblings. Life seems to be getting better, but soon she discovers that she and her real family have very different interests and outlooks on life. attempts to communicate invariably lead to scandals. The girl decides to communicate more with her father, the only one who understands her. After a while, the girl's birth mother goes to court again. She manages to sue the hospital for $1.5 million. It turns out that the woman, pretending to be a nurse, lost her child to a miscarriage. The tragedy pushed her to commit a terrible crime, kidnapping the newborn girl she has raised as her own. It sounds like a thriller plot, but this is a true story in the U.S. in 2017. The kidnapped girl, 18 years old, is named Kamaya Mobley, and her kidnapper is Gloria Williams. But there are far creepier cases of children who have been kidnapped and held captive by their captors for years, not in an atmosphere of love and care. For example, one December afternoon in 1972, 7-year-old Stephen Stainer got into a car with a man supposedly collecting donations for a church. Stephen reported that his mother could make such a donation, and the man lured him into the car under this pretext. He took the victim to a notorious pedophile named Parnell. With him, the boy lived for the next 7 years. He renamed him Dennis and introduced him everywhere as his son. The boy was too young to realize he had been kidnapped. Stephen thought his family had voluntarily given him away to his friend Parnell. The boy attended school with other children, but at the same time, he was constantly exposed to all kinds of violence from his abductor. When Parnell became interested in another child, 5-year-old Timothy White, Stephen couldn't take it anymore and decided to take Timothy to the police. The police recognized him and they returned both boys to their parents. Subsequently, Stephen married, had children, and had a good life. However, at the age of 24, he died in an accident. On the other hand, Parnell was sentenced to only 5 years. He was charged with kidnapping and child molestation. The pedophile was later charged with attempted child trafficking. The offender was sentenced to 25 years in prison and died in 2008. Another child who was unlucky enough to catch the villain's eye was J.C. Duggard. When she was 11, the girl was abducted on her way to the bus stop. JC's father witnessed the kidnapping, but he could not stop the car carrying the perpetrator, Philip Garrado. He spent 11 years in prison and was released 3 years before JC was kidnapped. While in prison, he managed to marry his cellmate's niece, Nancy. After his release, the couple set up their own business, a small printing business. After kidnapping JC, Garrado placed her in his specially built maze in the backyard. The room was so cleverly disguised that the police didn't realize it, even when they searched the house. Garrado abused JC, and she had 2 children with him. In 2009, the perp came under suspicion and was reported to the police. During a search of his house, 2 girls were found living there. JC was also found and was able to reunite with her mother after years of separation. Garrado was sentenced to 431 years in prison, while his wife and accomplice Nancy received 36 years. Our next victim is a young Chinese man, Gu Xinhan, who was abducted from the backyard of his home at the age of 2. This was done by a couple, a man and a woman. Then they sold him to a couple from central China. At the time, the sad practice of child abduction was widespread because of the one family, one child policy. The Chinese government had legislated to limit family size. Boys were kidnapped to look after their new parents, and girls were kidnapped to become brides for their only sons. Gu's father believed he would find his son and traveled more than 300,000 miles in search of him. On his travels, he carried a flag with the boy's image on it. He has also done extensive community work and has helped around 100 families find their missing children. Finally, in July 2021, DNA analysis and a unique facial recognition technology helped find his son. The kidnappers were caught and confessed to selling the 3 children. They are now in prison, awaiting the verdict of a judge, who will probably sentence them to death. Completing our selection is a 3-year-old toddler from the slums of Delhi. He was kidnapped while playing with other children. Railways in all directions were checked. His parents also promised a reward for any information about him. For 6 long years, they heard nothing from the boy. But one day, it was reported that he had been living with a new family for 2 years. It turned out that the man and the woman could not find his real family, and the boy could not say anything about himself, so they decided to adopt him. One day, neighbors of the adoptive parent saw a notice with a picture of the missing child and reported it to the police, who contacted the Natural family. The boy stated that he could not remember anything about what he was doing from 2012 to 2016. The abductor is a family member, or a close friend in most cases. In case the kidnapper is an outsider, he usually spends some time studying the victim's habits, his daily route. But in this case, the perpetrator couldn't be found. What do you think of these abductions? Have you ever heard of cases where the abductee returned home years later? Share your thoughts in the comments, and don't forget to like the video and subscribe to our channel if you like it.